Good morning, students of class 10. You are welcome back to the e-classes. Now we'll continue our lesson in history. We are doing nationalist movement in Indochina, and we have reached 3.1, the last portion of 3.1, plague strikes Hanoi and the problem with the sewer pipes. Let's go through this now. So far we have learnt about the French, modern part of the Hanoi city where French resided. It was a beautiful city. It was, the buildings were beautiful, well architect, modern architecture and modern engineering skills were employed to build this part of the Hanoi city where French resided. There their sewer pipes were laid underground, and that was the problem with them. It created a problem later on. What was the problem? Now you can see there, number one, this is the last part of this. The large sewers and their underground pipes in the modern part of the city of Hanoi, where French resided, a symbol of modernity. It was a symbol of modernity. The buildings were very beautifully built. A symbol of modernity were an ideal, ideal means very good, and protected breeding grounds for rats. The well-laid sewers, underground pipes, were a protected breeding ground for rats. Now after that, number two, the sewers and the pipes. The sewers also served as a great transport system for the rats, allowing the rats to move around in the city without any problem, without any hindrance. The rat entered each and every house through these sewer pipes, which was laid underground. Without any problem, the rat used to move around and enter the well-built, beautiful French houses. The rats began to enter the well-cared-for houses, beautiful houses, clean and beautiful houses, homes of the French, and that created the disease. The disease is spread among the French because they always remain clean. They are not used to the dirt. Vietnamese, they never caught this plague. They were never attacked by this plague because they are used to that. They are the inhabitants of Vietnam. They are used to that. But these French who came there and resided and started ruling Vietnam, they were very clean. They were not used to those kind of things, environment. So the rats began to enter the well-cared for homes of the French, and many of the French were hospitalized and they were attacked by the plague. Through the sewage pipes, these rats entered their homes through these sewage pipes. And what was to be done? How this problem could be solved? So that was a big question that rose among the French. What was to be done? Now here, now next, 3.2, we'll reach to another part, the rat hunt. There are 3 points, more will be, we will talk later on. Right now we have 3 points, rat hunt. 3.2, the stem, to stem this rat invasion. Invasion means attack, stem means stop. To stop this rat attack, attacked by the rats, a rat hunt was organized and started in 1902. A rat hunt was organized by the French because they were suffering from rats. Everything was eaten by the rats in their homes. They could see rats everywhere. So the French hired, hired means kept. The French hired Vietnamese workers. The French hired Vietnamese workers. You can see there. Let me bend a little bit. The French hired Vietnamese workers and paid them for each rat they caught. The French paid Vietnamese for the each rat they caught. They had to show the tail of the rat as a proof that they had caught the rat. So rats began to be caught in thousands. So the rats were caught in thousands. So now with this event we can see how the Vietnamese fought with the French in their everyday life. We will learn, because the Vietnamese were not fools. They used to catch the rat and clip the tail and show the tail to the French, and they used to get the money. They were paid. But they never used to kill the rats. They used to let go the rats, and the rats started breeding. It multiplied. It was an unending job. Thousands of rats were caught, and the Vietnamese, they received the money for their catch. In fact, many of the Vietnamese, they started raising rats in their houses so that they do not have to go to the sewer and catch the rats. They started raising the rats in their own homes, and they used to clip the tail as a proof they used to show, and they were paid. But the rats were alive and they started breeding. And every time they used to take the rats, the tail of the rats in bundles, hundreds of tails, and they were paid. In this way, the French treasury was practically empty. The treasury was empty, practically, because the workers were paid. But the problem was not solved. Millions of rats were there. So ultimately, the French had to give up this idea of hunting rats, because their treasury was practically empty. And the rats, the problem was not solved. They could still see the rats in their houses or homes. Not one, two, many. Wherever they could look, they could, wherever they saw or looked at, they used to see rats. Everything was eaten. Most of the French were hospitalized. They were sick. They were attacked by the plague. So the problem was not ended. So you can see that in this way, everyday life, the Vietnamese, they fought in their own way against the colonizers or the French. So we'll continue in our next class about the rat hunt. More are there, more points are there in the rat hunts. So that's all for today. Thank you very much for your presence, as well as you have paid so much attention and listened carefully and paid attention. Thank you very much. We'll meet in the next class and continue our lesson. Thank you very much. This much for today. We'll meet in the next class.